Have you noticed how women are always the ones having issues with in-laws? Don't get me wrong, some men might have few issues with mother-in-law or something, but most of the time is we women that used to have issues with in-laws, especially mother-in-laws, sister-in-laws, are always the one frustrating us. Let me go ahead and read this clip for you all to watch the end, then I'll come back and talk about it.
I'm beginning to think that the reason why women have so many issues with their in-laws, more so than men do, is because our society's idea about women is that we are accessible. Our mental, emotional, and physical labor is just free and accessible. So if we're the type who gets married and says, no, I'm not going along with that, I'm setting boundaries, I'm not going to be treated this way, actually, there is pushback, and so much of it, because we are not allowing access. So let's look at this on a broader scale. Look at what's happening in the United States with women's rights. Look what happened June 24th of 2022. Our society, our policies, our culture believes that women should be easily accessible and controlled. And that when we make choices for ourselves, such as setting boundaries with family members, we are told we are wrong, bad, evil, mean, just wait until you have kids, it's going to happen to you too, because we have made the choice for people, certain people, to not have access to us, because women are taught, be accommodating, be nice, just go along. And then when we get married and we say, no, we can't come over for all the holidays, for example, or we can't do X, Y, or Z, maybe because we have a prior commitment as a couple or for ourselves, we are then always scapegoated and blamed and treated like the bad guy. And what does it all boil down to? Choice. Women making an active choice to be autonomous, even though they're married to a man. And I've said it before, and Mel Hamlet said it in a video of mine she stitched today. Decentering your in-laws means decentering men. And how do we decenter? We make active choices, authentic to ourselves, based on our core values, while focusing or shifting your energy to what matters most to you.
Hey beautiful people, how y'all doing today? It's your girl Maria Davis and I'm back again with another interesting video. Why is the lie in this video? Because I can't find the lie. I can't find it because normally we women, we have been taught to look after others, to always put other people first before us, and that includes in-laws too. Your in-law. And when you decide to just do your own thing, choose yourself, they always come to tell you, try to emotionally blackmail you that, oh, you're also going to give birth, your own child, your own in-laws will do the same thing, or your child's wife or husband will do the same thing to you. Like, why don't they attack men like that? Why is it only women they do all of that? Why is it only women that always have in-laws issues and all of that? Because it's too much. When you ask almost every married person, I'm not saying all in-laws are a problem, but most of the time you always get, either from the husband side or the wife side, there's always one in-law frustrating one other person, and it's annoying, and it's something that most people are not even talking about. People are not talking about it, but it's happening. It's happening. But my own is that, why is it always happening mostly to women than men? I just have, I think, a stitch or two to share with you all. So let's go ahead and watch someone's reaction to this video. Then at the end of the video, I'll be back with my own opinion. But then let me know your thoughts about this video down in the comment section.
Women have so many issues with their in-laws, more so than men do, is because our society's idea about women is that we are accessible.
It's the expectations between men and women that differ. And it's this unspoken thing that women are supposed to do more than men do. More of the invisible labor, more of the emotional labor. Women are supposed to run themselves ragged if that means giving up what you have to do on a day-to-day basis in order to please your in-laws, or if they're going through a problem, you step in. If you're going through an emergency, you step in more than the husband does, even though that's his family. The expectation of that is wild. For instance, let's say something's going on in your family. No one will second guess that your husband's not there. Especially if you say something like, he has to work, or he's running late, or he just can't come. He has something else. The expectation, or let's say that the woman, he goes to something and they say, well, she's at work, or she's running late, or she just can't come. Then they're going to run their mouth because the expectation is you always make time for emergencies. You always make time for people. Even if you're tired, even if you have boundaries, women are not allowed to have boundaries. The moment that you have a boundary, they think that you are a bee. It's not fair. And the women who put their foot down and decenter their in-laws, I'm really loving this topic, by the way. Mm-hmm. The women that put their foot down and decenter their in-laws because they have way too much going on in their life because they just can't do it because they're trying to live. They're trying to break the cycle. They're trying to do something different. They're trying to teach their kids not to run themselves ragged. They don't want to live that life anymore. The moment you do that, they are going to hate you for it because the expectation of being part of their family comes with a price. And that price is invisible emotional labor. You're supposed to be front and center dealing with all kinds of crap because you married your partner. The moment that you say no, people are going to be looking at you sideways. And you're going to be the villain. Because undoing generational trauma, especially with people who don't want to hear it, it's going to be a lot. People are going to call you selfish. People are going to say, what about when it happens to you? People are going to mention your kids. People are going to mention you getting older. And what they don't understand is we're doing all this break the cycle for other people, for our kids, for other children that might be watching you and say, I don't have to do that. I don't have to go by the status quo. Anybody else who's watching is like, I thought I had to do this, but now I realize that I don't. I'm loving this creator because lately her videos have resonated with me. I'm loving the decentering your in-laws and extended family talk.
Decentering my in-laws was the best thing I did for my marriage. We have been taught as women that when we get married, we take on our husband's...
Y'all need to be paying attention to the way your significant other's parents treat you when you're dating, because that's just the tiniest window as to how they'll treat you when you get married. And pay attention to how well the family of your significant other communicates with each other. I feel lucky in saying that my relationship with my boyfriend's parents is great. My boyfriend has never once asked or expected me to be the communication liaison between him and his family. That just doesn't exist. If we have a party, a holiday, an event that we want to have with his family, Tyler is the one that takes care of all of that because it is Tyler's family. And I'm the same way with my family. If my family wants to do something, I am the person that organizes that for the two of us. Here's some harsh truth. If it's bad when you're dating, it's probably going to get worse when you get married. So, stay safe.
If you're still here, kindly let me know your thoughts, your comments, your suggestion, your opinion down in the comment section. All opinions are accepted. If you put them down respectfully, you know, feel free to agree or disagree. It's fine in this channel. You all, this video, I'm so sad I couldn't get a lot of stitch on this video. I feel like a lot of people have so many things to say because this kind of topic that people are not talking about, but it's happening. Like, it's happening. I think, do we need to decenter our in-laws? She said decentering in-laws means you're decentering men. See, in fact, seeing a white woman saying all of that, I was even thinking that this thing only happens where I am, because this thing is like the main thing. It happens where I am so much. Like, your in-laws, they will tell you to take your in-laws as your family. You must always go check on them. You must always be there, help, assistance. They might not be, if they are doing any activities and in your husband's family, you must be available. And not just physically available, you must be there before the preparation, during the preparation, after the preparation, you must be physically there. Some family self will tell you that you have to be the one to do some minor chores, you know, like washing of the dishes after the party. Probably all those, most of those ones are like the average or let's say low average kind of family that are not really boxed up like that. They'll tell you you'll be the one to do everything. You'll be the one to take care of children. Like, they just basically, you know, stress a woman when it comes to her going to her husband's side for in-law parties. But trust me, when it comes to the woman's side, if the woman that wants to do party, probably the family of the woman's side wants to do a party, they are doing a party and all of that. If the man is not there, number one, nobody's going to notice. Nobody's going to even call him and be like, "Now, what for you? You did not come. Why didn't you come?" Nobody's going to say that. What they're even going to be saying that, "Oh, I'm so sorry, you couldn't make it, blah, blah, blah." They will even call you. They will even call the man. And let's assume the man even made it to the party. He's not going to lift a finger. He's not going to do nothing. He's going to be served, giving some money, especially if the man now has money, it's over. He's not going to lift a finger. And it's easy for men to just get away with their in-laws. Men can decide not to even communicate with their in-laws at all. But women, if you don't communicate, there's a problem. They always hold you responsible. And when you decide to choose yourself, and probably there's an event, or aside from event, there's something happening and you don't want to be there physically, or you're not even like, "I'm not interested," they attack you. They make you feel like you're wicked or something. It's very hard for women to just choose yourself in this society. Generally, it's hard. And now seeing women, because most of the time now, it's not like before. If I'm talking about before, but now you see most family, when you ask them, "Is your in-law?" It's like, "I've not spoken to them for like a year. They're not even in Nigeria, or we're not in the same country." Like, everybody is living their life differently. Nobody is poke-nosing to each other. And this is actually making sense, because I feel like this is how it's supposed to be. But my own is, why is it so hard for women to choose yourself in this society? People must comfort them. Now, in-laws, men, everybody, okay? But my own question is, have you decentered your in-law before? Let me know how it's going. Let me know how it went. I'd like to hear your thought down comment section. Thank you all so much for sticking around to this point. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like and share and subscribe, and kindly turn on the post notification bell when you subscribe so you can get notified when I upload interesting video like this one. All right, thank you so much, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye.